What's up, everybody? It's Lethal Heir, and today's video, I just want to talk. This isn't going to be a high quality production, and I've really been stressing myself out trying to work on these projects. I have like 5 or 6 videos on the way, but they take so long, so much effort. But if you're new to the channel, if you're returning, I want to address some of the comments about, you know, questions around me streaming, when I'm going to stream. I don't know. And to be honest, I like streaming, but I feel like I had the same problem when I was trying to stream on PS4, trying to game and stream from the same piece of equipment. It's taxing. It's terrible. If I have really good settings in game so I can do good in game, then it just hurts the stream and makes it lag. And if I balance it, then I have to kind of take away from stuff that could showcase my skill. So what I mean is, like, when I'm streaming and gaming, it makes my game terrible and it makes the stream not as good as it could be. I think the best option for me right now, I'm trying to get my hands on a capture card. That way at least I can play PlayStation games and stream that. I would not mind that. Honestly, 60 FPS is kind of like eye death to me after playing on 240 frames. Yeah, 60 FPS, it just, but for the sake of streaming, that's something I'm willing to do. Just get a capture card, an Elgato, and stream from my PC, but play on my PS4. And in other ways, I'll be able to play with a lot of you guys, because most of you guys are on console, and there are some games like Call of Duty, especially with Modern Warfare. I missed the 2v2 alpha that was on the weekend, because I basically can't use my PlayStation right now until I get another hard drive. But hopefully I'll be getting a capture card soon, which isn't that expensive. I'll also be getting another hard drive for my PlayStation, and that way I can play some PlayStation titles and just at least have a stream. Now, for those of you who know about Ninja and his whole switch to Mixer, to be honest, like, no lie, I had just made a Mixer account like a month before that, and I was thinking, you know, I'd been streaming a little bit on Twitch. I was thinking about it, like, hey, you know, maybe I should try out this Mixer thing. They have a really cool feature that when you're close to winning your game in like Apex or Fortnite or a Battle Royale, then the hype channel or hype squad thing, it will go to channels that are closest to winning, and that way it's a little bit better. I remember streaming on YouTube. The worst part of streaming for me was I would eventually win once, you know, chat died down, there was no one to talk to. But when I did win, because I was focused, no one was there to see it. So that was a feature that I liked about Mixer. I honestly switched to Twitch because I wanted to stream on a different platform other than YouTube. Whenever you're streaming to YouTube and uploading, the stats, they don't really help, especially if you don't have a lot of people watching your streams. It'll basically almost treat it like a video that's not performing well. So I switched to Twitch, no reason other than just having a separate platform. That way my streams can do well, and then my videos can do well. And my videos are doing okay. When I was streaming to YouTube, my videos were only getting like 20 views after a week. So even though I don't have a lot of views on most of my vids now, at least getting 100 views in a couple days is so much better than going a whole week or two and not even cracking 50. So I wanted to also address some of the changes in Fortnite right now. I had played most of my games because I was just trying to go for hot drop clips. I didn't really care about getting mid-game and winning, so I didn't even notice. I looked at the patch notes. I looked at YouTube. I looked at Twitter and Twitch, and I just saw everyone freaking out about the new turbo building changes. And for those of you who didn't know, back around Season 4 is when they had nerfed the material strength. So back then, even though they still had turbo building, it wasn't as smooth as what you guys are probably used to by now, but it wasn't this slow. And it basically felt like you're building out of toothpicks when you're building out of wood. So the only viable materials, you know, for when you're getting spammed at in game, mid game, were like building out of brick and metal. They had buffed the health of metal and stuff. There's just so many changes, but you know, I'm a Fortnite veteran. I can say that. I've been playing since a little bit before Season 2, maybe a week or so. And, you know, this is about the 20th time, and I expect it. Epic Games, they change so many things. I know they want to include players that aren't as skilled But to be honest, there's no way to fix the problem of always being in lobbies with good players. It's just always going to be that sort of issue. So it's like, get good or just play creative and save the world. And that's just what it is. I really suffered a lot when I started playing Fortnite. I felt like I was still late. There was a lot of good players. I wasn't the best, especially when I moved to mouse and keyboard. A lot of you who have moved to mouse and key, you should know by now already that, yeah, it sucks being a bad player because there's so many good players. It's hard to even learn and get better. But the way the Epic Games has been doing these sort of changes in order to favor, you know, the majority of players who aren't pros, it's not at all elegant. And I'm quoting someone else. Those aren't my words, but it really just captures how I feel. And I feel like Epic Games could have done this change a little more effectively. But you know what? It's their game. They can do what they want with it. It's not going to make me play it knowing that. They could do what they want, but that's not going to be like, oh, I'm just going to play and I could do it what I want to, and so can you. So if Fortnite's the only game that you play, you probably want to add some other games. I've said this in the video before, you know, how to keep calm and stuff, and it's just like a mental strategy. If you're trying to have fun with games, especially with a game like Fortnite that is going to consistently have changes that are not good for most of the community, what you should definitely do is play other games. I mean, I'm not saying quit Fortnite. That's a little extreme. Fortnite's still a good game. I will find ways to enjoy it, and you should too, but find other games to play. You know, play Modern Warfare's coming out if you're on console, and there's definitely going to be crossplay. So hey, you know, who likes Fish in a Barrel? I like Fish in the Barrel. If you're on console, you think you can take me in Modern Warfare with my 240 frames? I might not even get 240. I'm just joking. But I mean, a lot of you guys are really good, regardless of being on console, regardless of only playing around 60 FPS. But I'm actually curious to see, you know, what crossplay in Call of Duty will finally be like. I mean, we've seen it in Fortnite, where a lot of console players are still doing really good in crossplay, but I want to see it in Call of Duty. I want to see it without the building, without all the editing and benefits that you have on PC. When it's straight up just gunfights, I think it'll be pretty much fairly even. I did hear that the aim assist in Modern Warfare is a little bit broken right now. I'm not sure what they intend to have in their beta and in the full game when it launches, but I'm definitely gonna pre-order that. If you haven't played the alpha, either you're on Xbox, PC, or you just didn't care, but if you missed the 2v2 alpha, it actually was really nice. I don't feel like I was missing much. I just want to see the multiplayer. But guys, I want to do a little bit more videos like this. Not too many. I mean, I really like the high quality production, but if you enjoyed this type of video, let me know. Talk to me in the comments section. You know, I have Twitter. What I want to start doing, I really hope they fix Fortnite's turbo building issue, but what I want to start doing is doing my team deathmatch. Even if I'm not streaming, I will still play with you guys offline. All you have to do is message me on Twitter or talk to me in the comments. I'll get your Epic and I'll invite you sometime. Every single day from about noon or 12 p.m. Central Standard Time, then I will be available. I may not be online exactly, but if you message me, I'll stop what I'm doing. A lot of times, unless I'm making a video, I'll stop what I'm doing and we'll play games. I actually haven't got any wins since the turbo building update, but it just takes me back. It kind of feels like season 4. It's not necessarily a bad thing, but I feel like the changes they made kind of punish players that aren't the best, you know? So anyway, I just wanted to update you guys on what I'm trying to work on to be able to stream. Like I said, I'm trying to get an Elgato capture card, which is probably something I can get within a week, you know? Get a capture card, stream from my PC, play games on PlayStation. I'm gonna have to buy a few games because I gave a lot of my games away. Other than that, hopefully we'll be streaming soon and playing something. It may not be Fortnite because, oh my God, not only do I not want to play at 60 FPS in Fortnite, but with the changes too, I don't know. It's been a long time since I played on PS4, but we're working on some stuff so I can stream again. And to be honest, between Twitch and Mixer, I'm kind of torn. Mixer seems really fun and I want to at least try it, but whatever platform, you know, those of you who, you know, are OG or whatever, or you, you know, whenever you joined this channel and became a member of this community, if you just like to see me stream, you know, you're the real MVP. There's a lot of people out here who are very picky, and I understand. There's a lot of people who start streaming Fortnite and I will only watch them. I will not watch them play Minecraft, or I'll watch them play Fortnite and that's about it. And so I understand, you know, no hate, no shade, but you know, for those of you who just like my personality and stuff, that's kind of what I want to bring. I know I've been working on a lot of tutorials and my tutorials aren't really going to help everyone. They're going to help some people. I don't really believe in all the flashy stuff and I'm not the best player in the world. I can only sort of help with a lot of the mental strategies, but that's another thing that you can be very vocal about down in the chat. If you want to talk to me, let me know, hey man, I think this ain't working, this or that, please be respectful. I have feelings, but I do value your opinion. We'll see you in another video, hopefully like this soon. So I really hope that the comments get popping, you know, when you guys will talk to me, and I'm looking forward to playing with you guys offline. There's a good chance I will record and upload it, but for those of you who are new, welcome. For the rest of you guys, we'll see you next time in another video. Peace.